Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to create a React app and add the Tabs component to it. The React Tabs component is used to organize related content in a compact space. The tabs are aligned horizontally, and each tab is associated with its header. In this video, you will learn how to configure the Tabs component with built-in features like different header styles, orientation modes, as well as scrollable or pop-up tabs when there are more tab items. And you'll learn how to initialize with HTML elements. Before proceeding, make sure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code and create a new application using the command npx create React app. I provide the app name, my React app. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the Tabs component, I type the npm install at Syncfusion / EJ2 React Navigations --- save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. For instructions on how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Since the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets. I import the tab component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. Then I include the tab component tag. Here I want to display information about two different programming languages. So, I add the tab items directive tag, which accepts n number of tab item definitions. Within this tag, I add two tab item directive tags. To use these tab items directive and tab item directive tags, I need to import them from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Navigations package. For these tabs, I plan to initialize the tab using a JSON items collection. So, I add the header property and set the text as HTML and Java in these tab item directive tags. Next, I am going to display content for the tab by adding the content property with the appropriate value. After that, I define the function HTMLContent. And set the text content. Likewise, I also set the content for another tab. Next, I need to add the CSS class property and set the appropriate class to override a few built-in CSS classes of the tabs component. After that, I need to add the CSS reference for the tabs component, so I open the app.css file and remove the default styles. Then, I import the material theme CSS reference. To align the component, I define CSS styles, including font size, padding, and text align. Now, let me save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. You can see the tab component shows the two different tab items. If I would like to change the tab header position to display at the bottom, left, or right, then I use the property header placement. To demonstrate, I am going to display the tab header on the left. So I add the property header placement and set its value as left. Now the tab header items are on the left side of the tab. you can see that no style is applied to the headers by default. To apply a specific style, you can either set predefined or custom classes to the tab root element. The available predefined classes are efill, ebackground, and ebackground eaccent. I am going to set a background color to the active tab header by assigning a predefined class efill to the CSS class property. And now you can see the active tab header has a background color. So far, I have shown you how to initialize the tab using the tab items. Next, let's see how to initialize the tab item using HTML. To do that, first I need to remove the existing tab items. And I change the header placement property value to top. Then, add the HTML division elements with the class attribute. I make sure that the header section is enclosed in a wrapper element using the etabHeader class, and that the corresponding content is mapped with the eContent class. I then add the appropriate header text and content for these division elements. Here, the tab component now displays with headers and content. If you display more tab items in the tab component, there is a chance that the tab header items will overflow the available space. In this scenario, you may need to specify the appropriate tab display mode. By default, when you add more tabs, the tab component makes the overflowing tab items scrollable. The available overflowing modes are extended, multi-row, pop-up, and scrollable. I first define the width property to show you how this default scrollable mode works. I define more division elements here and set the appropriate header and content to it. See that the tab header items are displayed in a single line with horizontal scrolling enabled at both ends. If I want to display those overflowing tab items in a pop-up, then I need to define the property overflow mode and set its value to pop-up. You can see in the tab component, when I click the down arrow, the overflowing tab header items are moved to the pop-up container like this. Next, I change the overflow mode value to extended. You can see when I click the down arrow, the overflowing tab header items are extended. Finally, I change the overflow mode value to multi-row. Now the header items are displayed in multiple rows. In this video, I have shown you how to add the tab component to a React application. I also showed you a few of its basic features. If you would like to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.